Hello children, this is Manakar, your science teacher. Today we are in lab again. So today we are going to tell you different equipments used in lab. So our objective is to study commonly used equipments in science lab. So let's start with this. Can you see this? This is a test tube. It is used to hold liquids. Liquids are packed in this. This is called test tube. See this blue colored stand. This blue colored stand is test tube stand in which these test tubes are kept properly. When anything is filled in the test tube, it is kept like this. See, listen, this is test tube holder. How it is used? When we heat up anything, we hold it like this. We hold it like this. This is test tube holder and this is test tube. Now let's talk about the next. This thing, this instrument, you can see this is fire tong. When we have to heat up anything, we just hold it by this and we can heat it up in the on the spirit lamp so that our hand won't be getting heat. I think this you can identify very easily. This is dropper. What do you do by this dropper? We use it to fill liquid, small amount of liquid through this dropper and pour like this. This is dropper. The next is, these are the glass slides. These are the glass slides. These are used to make permanent ponds of animal or plant material. And children, as we have already read, this is microscope and this is studied under the microscope. This permanent slide can be studied under the microscope by adjusting it. See children, this is watch glass. This is watch glass. In this, small tissue of any plant or animals is kept. And when we prepare permanent mounds, so the mound of the onion peel, we put like this small with the help of dropper. Now this is a box of cover slips. See, I can show you. These are the small glass pieces, square glass pieces. Can you see it? Yes, it is visible now. It is used to cover permanent mounds. It is used to cover permanent mounds. I mean, when we prepare any slide, it is used to cover it with very, very slowly to cover the slides, to cover the material. These are cover slips. Now children, this is beaker. These beaker measure in different quantities. They may be, this is of 250 ml, this is of 100 ml, it may be of 50 ml. It is used to measure and to make solutions. And see children, this is glass rod. This is glass rod. It is used to mix anything, any solution, or the stir any solution like this. As I have put some copper sulfate in this beaker and added water, and I am dissolving it with the help of this glass rod. Now this is a funnel. This is funnel, glass funnel. This is conical flask, as its shape is conical, flat bottom. This is conical flask. It is also used to measure different chemicals. Now children, you can see this paper, this paper, this is filter paper. How do you use this? It is used, we fold it like this, then we fold again like this, then we make a cone out of it. We put this cone in this funnel, then we put it in any vessel like this, and we can filter any solution by pouring the liquid in this. You can see, children, the liquid is poured down. Slowly and slowly, liquids pour down. So by this process, filtration is done with the help of filter paper. Now, the next is, these are the boxes of litmus paper. This is red and this is blue. You can see clearly, red and blue litmus paper. These are the indicator. In class 7th, you have read this. These are the natural indicators made up of lichens. See, I will show you the strips of these litmus paper. You can see, this is a strip of red litmus paper. This is the red litmus paper. Now this is blue litmus paper strips. These are blue litmus paper strips. By which different solutions or liquids can be heated. And this is, as you know, tripod stand. Three legs are there, you can see it. It is kept like this. This is wire gauze. When anything we can heat it up, we use this wire gauze on this tripod stand. Like this. Yes, children, now you can see this is microscope. It is commonly used in biology lab, by which we can see the things clearly, very minute things, very small things clearly, because it magnifies the thing we observe, we want to observe. So that's all, children, for today's class. Hope you must have enjoyed it. And let's see again the liquid I am stirring with the glass rod in the beaker. This is copper sulfate solution. Okay. Thank you.